So we've had a good start with Arsenal in the Life After Wenger Challenge, and well, 7 points in three games, but a tough Champions League group, and that is what we've got today, a Champions League match, so let's get into it. Hey guys, welcome back to some more Football Manager 2017 and part 2 of season 1 of Life After Wenger, obviously at Arsenal. And today we have that Champions League match, as I said in the intro, against Roma. So, before we get into things, let's have a look at the last three matches that we've played. We beat Tottenham in the North London Derby 2-1, Mesut Ozil and Theo Walcott scoring there. We then disappointingly drew 1-1 with Hull. We just really didn't turn up to this game, and it was only because of a wonder goal from Romelu Lukaku at the end that we actually got out of that without defeat. And then we thumped Middlesbrough 4-0, Cazorla, Barkley and Walcott getting on the score sheet. We also had no goal to contend with as well. So in the Premier League, I mean, the media are already saying we're off to a poor start, but 7 points in four games isn't the worst thing. If we can win our next Premier League match, that'll move us up to 10, and I think 10 points every five games is about par if you want to be up there challenging for the title. So Liverpool, funnily enough, bottom of the table, no points so far. Everton only got one, so it's really not good on Merseyside at the moment. Rather than red or blue, it's very much black at the moment. Dark times for them ahead. Chelsea only 14th, but we're only four games into the season. It's not going to be too relevant. Champions League group, as I said, is a tough one. We've got Real Madrid, we've got Lyon and Roma, so yeah, it's going to be tough to get out of this. Certainly winning the group, and that's going to mess up our chances to get to the quarterfinal, but hopefully we can do alright. Squad performances, we'll have a quick look. Top goal scorer is Theo Walcott with 2. Top assist is Lukaku with 2, and top average rating is Luke Shaw, who has finally came into the squad. Should have probably said that in the intro. Luke Shaw has joined the club for £30 million, and yeah, I think he'll be a good sign. And we also we're letting Monreal go. He's going in January for £7 million or something like that. So let's have a look at the team for today. We've got Petacek, Ingo, we've got Bellerin, Mustafi, Koscielny and Shaw in defence. We've got Ramsey, Xhaka and Barkley in the middle, with Santi Cazorla starting behind Sanchez and Lukaku. So Sanchez back after his suspension. He got sent off in the whole match, which he got fined 2 weeks' wages for, and was banned for a couple of games. So he's back today. We're just going to send my assistant to that, because I can't be bothered to read them. Here we go then. Let's get into things. Come on, Arsenal. Let's get off to a good start in the Champions League. It's going to be tough this year, as I've said. Transitioning from Arsene Wenger isn't going to be the easiest thing. Here's Alexis Sanchez, who puts us 1-0 up. He's made up for his misdemeanours in getting sent off. Might download a Premier League kit pack. I've just noticed that we haven't got the proper away kit, so might download that at some point. But yeah, 1-0 within the first 5 minutes, that's all I can really ask for, to be honest. Aaron Ramsey with the assist puts through Alexis Sanchez, who smashes it with his second touch into the top left hand corner of the goal. And we have changed to the 4-3-1-2. I don't know if you noticed in the tactics screen, but we'll actually have a look at half time, because the 4-2-3-1, we just weren't taking our chances with it. We were getting plenty, and we looked up for it, but couldn't quite get the goals that were needed. It was after the whole game that I changed it to the 4-3-1-2, and we had a very good performance against Middlesbrough, so I thought that's what we'll do. We'll go with that for a while, and it kind of excludes Walcott and Chamberlain and people, but I do have plans for changing the tactic up a little bit, maybe away from home. But here's Cazorla now, Lukaku, nothing happened there. Dzeko, oh, it's a good save by Dzeko, good save. Mustafi, I mean, we did beat Tottenham 2-1 with the 4 4-2-3-1, so it does work. It does work, but we're going to go with this setup away from home. We're going to be a bit narrower and just try and focus our moves through the middle, getting the ball to Sanchez and Lukaku, hopefully. But Lukaku having another poor game, we may have to have a little word with him on the little team talk thing and just say we demand a bit more from you. He hasn't had the best of starts at Arsenal. I mean, 54 million was a lot to spend on him. Bring in Giroud, put him as a target man. See what he can do on that. We'll put Sanchez behind the striker as a shadow striker, and we'll bring on Walcott as well. We'll see what that does. Play him as a false nine. That could work. Could work. Let's see. Got 25 minutes to go. I would like another goal here just to feel a little bit more comfortable. Oh, I could have got a Walcott, but here's Ramsey now. Barkley, Koscielny, Bellerin, Ramsey, Alexis Sanchez, Theo Walcott, who puts it in the back of the net. 2-0. His third goal of the season, and another assist there for Alexis Sanchez. And he's had a very good game as Sanchez, warranting his new contract. We did give new contracts to Sanchez and Ertzl. Obviously, very topical at the moment, that as well, whether they'll leave in the summer, because I've only got 1 year left on the deal, but that's not what I wanted. It's 2-1. I don't really know who to blame for that, but you know, it's overall been a good performance. I mean, Roma have had more shots and stuff. We are kind of mugging them at the minute, but you know, we'll take it. Certainly take it. Here's Barkley. Now Barkley again. Ramsey forward to Giroud. Ramsey, nope. Oh dear, Salah, good save. Very good save. That could be very important in Champions League qualification. A good start here. Getting the 3 points. Just sticking with Real Madrid. I'll take it. If we end up level on points with Real Madrid, we'll definitely be happy with that. They only beat Lyon 2-1 anyway, away from home. So, you know, I'd say Lyon and Roma are fairly similar team. Southgate was there, apparently, looking at Luke Shaw and Barkley, to the new signings, of course. So, when are we going to come back? That is the question. I think we will come back for a double episode. Who will we play? Should we do West Ham and Real Madrid? Does that sound good? I have a few games in between, and then we'll come back for them two games. And then maybe do Real Madrid and Liverpool after that. I think that'll be fun. So, yeah, we'll be back for West Ham and Real Madrid in the next episode. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed. Please leave a like down below if you did. You don't have to, of course, but mean a lot for me and for the channel. Make sure you share it out with your friends on Twitter, Facebook, anything you want. I really do want this series to do well, and it would mean the absolute world if you could just direct them to this series, part one or this one. It really would mean the world. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day, and goodbye.